Hey guys, let's get some light. What's up? I just finished editing the last video that I posted. This is part two of that video to show you how I'm cooking this crab. I'm sure most of you guys know how to steam a crab, but we're gonna do it anyways, and we're gonna eat it, and we're gonna enjoy it, and we're very grateful to have some fresh seafood finally. This is what's going on here in the kitchen right now. It's dinner time for Mr. Elo, and
he's a baby.
He has to have hand feed.
And Frankie
steals pieces every time. We got some water boiling. And here's our crab. This thing is massive. The points are huge. I don't know how much this is, and I highly doubt we're gonna measure it. Do you guys hear that? Okay, so this is our little rigged up steamer situation. Just a pot with a colander and a top on it. So, did you put beer in here?
Mm-mm.
What? I always hate this part. This is so sad. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for this delicious crab. We are going to thoroughly enjoy it, and we're so grateful to have some fresh seafood. We worked our tails off for this one crab. Oh man, I always hate that part. These little things that my mom put up here.
And the mom that's on the cake.
The next step is to add your Old Bay seasoning. Here, I wish I had the original Old Bay seasoning, but I don't. I've got the garlic and herb. So I'm gonna put a heap amount on there.
What's whoa?
I'll show you.
Do me first.
So you go like this, and then with this hand, you go like, or no. Yeah, do it again, but like with a little shake motion, like you're earthquaking while you do it. No, that your right arm goes straight.
Straight where?
Down. Yeah. Oh well.
Oh, like. Whoa.
All right, guys, we're gonna go eat this crab now.
All right. Sip of this beer.
So, first things first.
We've been waiting for how long? Oh
Jeez.
No, mine's all foamy. I hate that. And you wipe this.
We got some Texas peas. Why can't I talk right now?
Because your
mouth is watering. All right, got some Texas peas.
Texas Pete hot sauce.
This is so funny. Oh my gosh, there's Captain Apple Daniels.
He has one of those like that too. I've made that mistake before.
Texas Pete, like she said, we got some cocktail sauce as well. We've got our one crab here. Our beautiful prized possession. Saltine crackers, a little bit of lemon. We're ready to go. All
right. I'm gonna let Heidi just break it right in two.
And so we'll split it right in half.
For this one crab, please nourish our bodies with it, and thank you for letting us catch it. And
bless all of the people who are not able to. I am really laughing. She is the worst person human there ever was. Can I say the blessing, please? Very grateful for this crab, for this harvested meal, and some fresh seafood on our plate, and we hope that everything can go back to normal very soon so that we can all get back to loving and living the outdoors and being together.
Amen. And we do pray for all of those families that have lost their loved ones. We do pray for them.
We're all in this together, and we're thinking of you all. So,
God bless.
Amen. It's gonna be a nice, quick little tutorial here. So we got one crab, like she said. We're gonna split it. It's nice and hot still. So I wonder if they can see. Pull the little bottom off, and then you just stick your thumb underneath. Pop the top shell off of there. And a lot of people will eat this right there. That's what a lot of people consider caviar. I think it tastes pretty good. It's pretty sweet.
Yeah, a lot of people like that right there called the caviar. And then what she's picking off right now are the lungs, which you do not want to eat.
Yeah, my dad always called them dead man's lungs or something like that. Dead man's lungs, because he said if you eat one, then you'll die. But I don't know if that's true or not, but those are the lungs. You just pull those off right there, and it's pretty much ready to split. Just crack her right in half. Just like that.
Yes. Oh, it's gonna be so good.
Bon appetit.
And what you could do is like pull each little paw out right here at a time, and sometimes a nice piece of meat will come out, sometimes it doesn't. If not, you'll get it when you crack the inside of it out. I haven't gotten a big one yet, but yeah, but I'm gonna open up all of these little shells like this, the legs. Even if it doesn't come out, it's a little work, but it's all worth it.
Yeah, it's part of the experience that I like, just like sitting here and taking it with a beer. And I think everybody has their own method, don't you?
Like watch this, we don't have a cracker or anything like that, so I'm taking a butter knife. I'm gonna just put this little bit on a cracker, just because I've been craving it for so many days, maybe months. So what I like is just a little bit of Texas Pete on my cracker with it. I don't need the cocktail sauce and all that stuff. I'm gonna go for it.
Go for it. She did. Good?
It's good, but I'm going to have a little more meat on the next one. I taste it with Texas Pete and saltine cracker.
Y'all. I actually like to add a little Old Bay, but
I bet that's going to be all you got out of your crab right there. You got more? Wow. I haven't gotten to my meaty part yet. That was just out of this leg.
Oh, yeah. I haven't done the leg yet.
And on this one, you just lift this little thing up and hope the meat comes out. But the cartilage did, not the meat. So, got to pick it out, too.
So good.
Come summer, we'll be thinking, oh, just give us a cool spring day. But lately, it's been like, no, give us some hot, hot weather with no wind.
I don't know why I can't talk right now. I think based on that response, you are planning on staying all summer?
Oh, if I can go home, then I need to do that too. But we'll have to see, won't we?
We just don't know how long this craziness is going to last. So delicious. But what are we going to eat for dinner? Number two.
A lot of meat on that one.
Mm-hmm.
Don't hurry up, she's gonna leave me out here sitting by myself. It's the meat part.
Yeah, that's got the most meat.
It's still so warm. Good.
But I don't know about where you guys live, but here, I mean, I'm sure most places are doing it, but the Instacart or like Food Lion pickup. So we go and pick up groceries and they just bring it out to your car. We've only done that once so far since this whole thing started, but we have to go tomorrow and do it for the second time. And I mean, it's much better than going into the grocery store. I think it's a lot safer, but we still have to wear gloves. We're gonna wear masks. We're gonna take Clorox wipes and wipe down every single item, take our shoes off, strip down as soon as we get in the garage, put our clothes in the laundry, And I don't know, it's just all so crazy. It's like, whoever would have thought that you'd have to do that just to get groceries? But we saw the cutest old lady at the post office the other day. She was going inside and she didn't have any gloves or a mask or any, probably even any hand sanitizer. They don't know how to like help themselves in situations like this. Like, this is all so crazy, and especially when the grocery stores don't have any supplies. Like, if you didn't get them right off the bat or can't find somewhere online to order them, then you don't have anything. And you should try to help people like that if you see them, because they're vulnerable and they need our help, like the elders.
So yeah, I walked back to the door, opened it because I had a Clorox wipe, and then when she came back out, I handed her one out of my car, and she really didn't need to say anything. She didn't. She just took it graciously.
She
and
was so cute.
I think was very thankful, and her husband was sitting in the car watching, and it was very sad. I mean, I wish we knew their name. I would love to go pick up some groceries for them or something.
I mean, to get on the website, go through, pick out your groceries, and put in your card info, like all of that. It's something that I don't think a lot of older people can figure out. I know my dad, for instance, couldn't figure it out. Yum, that's a good one.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna finally taste some crab meat. Mm-mm-mm.
These claws are hard to...
Patience, patience, patience. Just like fishing. Can't catch a fish every cast, but it's so rewarding after all of your patience. What fun would it be if you caught a fish every cast? Not fun.
Really?
No.
It's gotta be pretty fun.
Well, I do remember back in the day when I would come down here.
Back in the day.
I loved it. I mean, I didn't mind catching the little spot, the little blow toads, the little... I didn't care what it was. It was small. It was fun. I'd put some back. I'd save some for bait. I'd eat a lot of fish while I was down here. Seems like it was in the dead of summer, and it was always the old codgers, same old codgers that came down. They'd have their smokers going and smoking fish. They'd share that with us, and we'd share our fish with them. It was fun. That was back when we used to stay down at Kildevil Hills, Nag's Head area, at the Orville or Wilbur Wright. We had a little cottage there. Across the street with their smokers going. Wasn't really crowded back then. I'm talking probably 35 years ago. At least.
Yeah, tell them the story of how y'all used to bring me down as a little munchkin, and all about,
well,
our history at the Outer Banks.
Yes. I think Heidi was conceived at the Outer Banks to begin with, so that was a little surprise.
A surprise?
February. We brought her every year, at least four times a year. Couldn't wait to get here. We taught her how to fish as soon as she was old enough to stand up and hold a rod. Daddy taught her a lot too. He was just as helpful back in those days. Taught my son and Heidi how to fish. Taught me how to fish, what to use. And we just have a lot of patience, and we still love it. Still eating crabs too. That's
oh,
my
Lord.
Last
That's
good,
a good bite.
Bite.
I've Mm-mm. still got one claw left. The big claw. Did you get a lot of meat out of that?
Mm.
A Mm-mm. little bit.
Not a lot.
I'll try to get one more cracker. But some of my favorite memories of like coming down here as a kid was just going to the beach and loading up the cars and just being out there all day long, like down at the point
in Buxton, and it seems like we always caught fish too.
Always, exactly.
And then we go home that night, all sunburnt and tired, windblown, salty, and get in the kitchen, and we cook whatever we caught.
And honestly, we would get out there no later than 10 and stay sometimes until after dark if the fish were coming in.
I mean, no offense if any of you guys do this, but I don't understand how people go to the beach and they don't fish.
Catching,
put it in the cooler.
And then rigging up again. It's called, we always said it was, should I say it?
F-F-ing around, y'all look it up.
F-F-ing around. Fiddle is the first word, okay. And I still use that term today because it is. You're just, and the time just flies by. That was so good.
Couldn't you eat about it?
But you know what? That was just enough to just
make you want to go crabbing more.
Well, I always want to go crabbing, but just to appreciate the bountifulness when you get it.
Yeah. Cheers. Ha! Cheers to our next adventure and catch. Hopefully very soon. I need to do some sort of ritual to break this curse.
Why don't we start the burner back there and put a little bit. We got some dried wood now. Put the dried wood in there. Just do a little bit and we'll just do a little dance around the fire pit.
Okay. All right, y'all. So we are about to do a quick little seance. Ritual burn here to get rid of any bad juju that I have been talking about. Got a little clump of cilantro here. I need to take my hair down. I need to get rid of this fishing curse, so y'all, let's see if this works.
That hair's blowing that way. Yeah. Cleanse this body, all of this, to bring us fishing luck and powers and patience. I think we have great patience, but
we definitely have good patience. Let all the bad juju flow out. Bring only good juju. Yeah. Catching fish, crabs, yeah, clams, oysters, yeah, scallops,
and
all of it.
Do you think you want some more of this, fire?
Home.
I'm a bottom rigger, so.